On this episode of At Home with Eastbrook Homes, we are talking with Kim Southwick. She recently was on an episode of House Hunters with an Eastbrook home. We're going to put that whole story together next on At Home with Eastbrook Homes. And as I said on this episode of At Home with Eastbrook Homes, we were talking to Kim from Five Star. Kim, for people who don't know you, I know that you're kind of a household name in and around West Michigan, but for people who have not used you, how long have you been in the space and how did you get into real estate?
Yeah, I've been helping people buy and sell real estate for about 7 years now, and I got into it. Basically, I love new homes, new home construction, actually. And so years ago, I actually sold new homes. And then when the big recession came, I worked in sales and marketing for a local company. And then after, you know, I was done with that, I thought, you know, I really love the whole process of buying and selling real estate. I love working with clients. So that's when I started. And I love it.
So, Kim, we have you on because HGTV seems to really love Grand Rapids. This is the second episode that they've aired this year. And you are on House Hunter. So I want to start at the beginning. How does that process work? Like, what is the courtship like? And how do you be a part of a House Hunters episode?
Yeah, you know, it's something I've never really known about. I've never, you know, known anyone who's done it. So I went into this blindly, not knowing anything. But actually, last year, last January, I received an email, and it was from like an unusual name. And, you know, I didn't recognize it, but it said that they were casting for house hunters in the area, and they were looking for a specific buyer profile. And I thought two things. One is this a scam? And you don't get emails like that every day, right?
Yes. And it had a Venmo link at the bottom of it.
Yeah, exactly. And if you'd like to apply, just give us your number, social security number, right? And then the other thing is I didn't have someone who really fit the buyer profile. I had a couple who was looking for what they were looking for, but they were older, and I know from watching the show that they weren't real animated, so I didn't know that they'd be real good on TV. So anyway, I just kind of kept that email. And then a couple of months later, I started working with a client, and this client I know pretty well. I've helped her buy and sell a couple of other times. She's a repeat client, and she's young, and she was downsizing. And I thought, you know, you don't see that very often for her being so young to actually downsize. So I thought, you know, hey, I'll just put this out there, and then we'll see if this email was a scam. So anyway, I just replied and told them, you know, what I had, if they were interested. Well, they immediately put me in touch with some casting producers. And so I went through that process. And then after that, they're like, you know, how does your client feel about doing something like this? Because I hadn't even talked to her yet about it. So, So then I was like, this was over a couple of months where I was talking to the producers. And then I asked my client, and I said, hey, are you up for something fun? And she's like, yeah, what do you got going on? So I told her, and she thought about it. And she's like, yeah, why not? Sounds like something fun. And then after that happened, it was quick. We auditioned through kind of like what we're doing, and we auditioned, and we got an email the next day saying that we were chosen, and then they were here like a week and a half later.
Walk me through, you know, the prep I got heading into this, Kim, was that this was more, I guess when you watch the show, you don't anticipate it takes more than a day or two to kind of do this, because it feels as if it's 24 hours. I mean, I know the magic of TV, but how long was the process from they show up in Grand Rapids and start filming till they wrap filming and then start editing?
Okay. Actually, that was a couple of weeks. It took a couple of weeks to, oh my gosh, the days are long, really long days. And it was during the middle of summer and one of the hottest months we've ever had. And a couple of the homes did not have air conditioning. So there was a whole crew and us all, you know, shoved into these tight spaces and, you know, it's hot and humid and all that. But yeah, it was a couple of weeks of filming.
We've obviously seen the episode. It aired on November 12th. If you haven't seen it, you can get it anywhere that you have a TV provider. But I'm wondering if you could maybe give us some anecdotes that didn't make the final cut, because obviously if they're shooting for weeks, they're shooting a ton of content.
Yeah. Okay. There was so much that didn't actually make it into the show. But first off, I gave a lot of commentary on the Grand Rapids area and very little of that was put in. So I was kind of disappointed with that because I really wanted to promote Grand Rapids and how great it was to live here in the area and everything. And they kind of really, squished it down a lot. Let's see here. There was one house that we went through. This was funny. And my client, she goes, "Ooh, this smells." And then she turned around. She's like, "Can I say that?" And the producer, you know, they were like, "Yeah, that's fine. I mean, if that's your reaction, that's fine." So we thought that that might be in there, but it wasn't. Let's see there. Yeah. There are a lot of like reaction type things that were like really natural that just happened on the fly that didn't actually make the final cut. So I think we're a little surprised about that. And then of course it's just all the content that is shot that just isn't used. It's just so surprising when you see it down in to the 22 minutes or whatever it is that you're like, this took a couple of weeks and you know, Yeah. And, you know, I don't know. It just seems like the part about the not having air conditioning, it seems like that would have been in there too, because that's kind of a thing that people want when they buy a house.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
You know, and then there were a lot of things that I couldn't say, that, you know, like I was talking about how, people are working more mobile these days. I mean, everybody knows that. Right. Sure. And they didn't want me talking about that. And so there were a lot of things that I would go to say, like I would say, you know, this home really satisfies a lot of the things that my client's looking for. And she's like, "You don't want to say that either." So it was kind of frustrating, to be honest. There were a lot of things that I would say that are in my normal everyday when working with clients, you know, my normal jargon. And I just couldn't use it. So at the end, the final scene where we are in her condo that she chose, and I had brought over some wine and a basket for her, you know, wine and some kind of, you know, treats and that kind of thing. So anyway, I go to open the bottle of wine. Well, first off, I didn't have an opener, and because she wasn't living there yet, she didn't have an opener. So we had to go ask a neighbor for a wine opener. And then I didn't know how to use that wine opener. Oh my gosh. They were filming at the time and we were laughing so hard because I could not get the dang cork out of the bottle. And yeah, that didn't make it either. You know, comedic relief at the end of it, but nope.
At the end of this, she obviously ends up in Riverbend. Can you tell me about this? Because obviously we only get a glimpse of this single part of Riverbend. Can you tell me more about where we are in Michigan? It's in Belmont, but what that property looks like and what it has to offer.
I knew she was gonna like this one for sure. Riverbend is a great community. It is condos, and there are some single family condos, or we should say detached condos, and then some that just have one shared wall, like a duplex type unit. So that's another thing too, is they were not familiar with the whole detached condo situation. So we had to really kind of educate them on that. But yes, it's in Belmont. It's off from West River Drive. And one of the really nice things about it is it's right next to a park and it's not far from the Grand River. So there's a lot of like recreation right around there. And it's a really nice smaller community that has a really nice kind of like small town feel to it. And you feel kind of secluded back in there off the road because you think, oh, it's off West River Drive. It's going to be busy, but it's not. It's set back in. You don't hear traffic. And it's just a really nice, quiet neighborhood that, you leave 5 minutes later and you are, you know, back in the thick of things. So it's a great community. And a lot of the homes have beautiful sunrooms and they're beautiful condos. If somebody hasn't seen them, I'd be glad to show them, but they're absolutely beautiful and you can do a lot of customization. And that's what I love too about Eastbrook Homes. I've sold lots of Eastbrook Homes in the past and, you know, they allow for a lot of customization and, you know, yours can look totally different than somebody else's. So there's a lot of options and there's a design center to pick everything out. And, you know, it was a great process.
So Kim, you obviously have a knack with your clients. Can you tell me about what you love about the space? You were in it early, you left at the recession, then came back, you know, when there aren't cameras around, you're doing this same work. The cameras just kind of amplify kind of parts of your personality. But can you tell me what it is about this that you love doing?
It's just rewarding. It's so rewarding working with your clients and getting them to the next stage in their life and helping to guide them through that. I mean, people don't buy and sell homes every day. It's not something that you do all the time. The average homeowner does it every 7 to 10 years, although Amelia's done it more than that. But, you know, typically you're guiding them through a process that they haven't done in a while. And real estate changes too. It's always changing. I guess that's one thing that I love about my job too, is no 2 days are the same, but I just love working with my clients and being their trusted advisor. And it's an honor for me that they actually, you know, trust me to bring them through this process. And I love, like I say to them, if you could wave a magic wand, what would you want to happen in this process? Like I'm currently working with a client who wanted to find a home really fast and be in it before Christmas. And this was just a few weeks ago. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, that's a big task. That's a big one. You know, sell her home, find a home and be in. And, you know, by the skin of our teeth, it looks like that's going to happen, but you know, I love the challenge of it too. And I just like making people happy. It's amazing.
So I would be remiss if I didn't ask you this question, and I'm not necessarily asking you to look into some sort of crystal ball, but with your wealth of knowledge, what do you think 2024 is going to be like?
Yeah, that's a good question, right? From everything that we are seeing from the economists and from lenders, that kind of thing, we're seeing that interest rates are expected to go down probably second quarter of 24. And what that's going to do is spur on more buyers. It's going to bring out more buyers the minute the interest rates, you know, start easing up and going down. Right now, there's a really tight supply of inventory, as there has been for a while. So it's a really unique kind of market in that the number of transactions are down like 20%, yet we have such buyer demand. And so still, so I think that we're either going to see the market just kind of be flat to this year, or actually it could go up. And we just saw a prediction that just came out yesterday that it is going to go up. The number of transactions will go up next year. So that's what we're seeing.
Kim, if people want to connect with you and have them be your guide through this process, what is the best way for them to do that? How's the best way for them to get a hold of you?
Yeah, call or text 616-309-6121. I'm on Instagram at Sold with Kim. And my website is kimsouthwick.com.
And if you want to learn more about the Riverbend property at Eastbrook Homes, you head to eastbrookhomes.com. Kim Southwick, have a wonderful holiday season. And I would actually love to catch up with you next year and kind of see where we're going in this market.
Oh, absolutely. I'd be more than happy to. Happy holidays to you.
If you want to learn more about Eastbrook Homes and the new home opportunities throughout West Michigan and the Lansing area, just head to eastbrookhomes.com.